Hello, my dear students. Welcome you in science class. In last lecture, we have seen kinetic energy, potential energy as different forms of energy. And we brief about law of conservation of energy. In last lecture, we have discussed that we cannot create or destroy energy. What we can do is only transform or change one form of energy into another form of energy. In previous lecture, we have seen some example of conversion of energy. For example, we have seen example of bulb, light bulb, that converts electric energy into light energy and heat energy. In last lecture, we have discussed that how bulb generate heat. After switch on the bulb, we can feel that bulb feels comparatively warm. After more time, it feels hot. So that is the conversion of electric energy to heat energy. So we can say that is a conversion of electric energy into heat energy and light energy. After that, we have seen some example of conversion of energy. We seen that we use automobile vehicles that converts chemical energy to mechanical energy. They use petrol, diesel, CNG, LPG kind of fuel. This fuel contain energy in form of chemical energy. And with the help of engine, by igniting these fuels, we can convert this chemical energy into mechanical energy. So we have seen two statement of law of conservation of energy. There is, we note the sentences, energy can only be converted from one form to another. It can neither be created or destroyed. So that is the statement for law of conservation of energy. We have also seen that the law of conservation of energy is a universal law because it can be applied to any kind, all kinds of transformation and in all situations. So this is the universal law. After that, we have seen one example. We have take object with mass m, and this object it is at certain height initially. Say it is at height h, and the object is stationary at this position. So at that time, at stationary position, it has only potential energy in it, and the potential energy is mgh. We derive the formula for potential energy in previous lecture, that is mgh. When we release this object, what will happen? This potential energy gets converted into kinetic energy. And as time passes, potential energy decreases and kinetic energy increases with time. But here we have to notice that the sum of potential energy plus kinetic energy remains constant at all time and at all point of object path. Potential energy plus kinetic energy remains constant. Potential energy plus kinetic energy, the sum of these two energy remains constant. Now we have formula for both the energy, potential energy, that is mgh, and kinetic energy, that is half mv square. And we give this sum name is mechanical energy. Mechanical energy, the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy of object is its total mechanical energy. So we can say that at all time total mechanical energy remains constant. We find that during the free fall of object, now we understood what is free fall of object. Free fall is the condition when only gravitational force exert on the object, no any other external force exert on the object. We find that during the free fall of object, the decrease in potential energy at any point in its path appear as equal amount of increase in kinetic energy. Decrement in potential energy is same as increment in kinetic energy, because we have total kinetic energy plus potential energy should be constant or must constant. So decrement in potential energy is equal to increment in kinetic energy. Here the effect of air resistance on the motion of object has been ignored. We know that when we release the object in our regular atmosphere, it has some air resistance. But in this case, we ignore this air resistance. In previous chapter, we discussed that if there is no air resistance, time for reach the ground of any object with different mass is same. If we release lightest thing and heaviest thing in gravitational acceleration, gravitational force, in absence of air resistance, we can notice that both reach the ground level at same time. But when there is no air resistance, so here also we ignore air resistance. There is thus continual transformation of gravitational potential energy into kinetic energy. There is continuous transformation of gravitational potential energy into kinetic energy. We can see when activity 11.15 related to the last statement we have seen. We have an object. It has mass 20 kg. And we drop this object from 4 meter height. Fill in the blanks in the following table by computing the potential energy and the kinetic energy in each case. And for simplifying calculation, we can have G as 10 meter per second square. We know that the value for gravitational acceleration small g, we know that the value for gravitational acceleration g is 9.8 meter per second square. But here, for sake of simplicity in calculation, we take value of g as 10 meter per second square. Here we have different height of object at different time interval. Say we have object at 4 meter, 3 meter, 2 meter, 1 meter, and just above the ground, that is we can say 0 meter. Potential energy, now we have formula for potential energy, that is mgh H. Kinetic energy, we have formula for kinetic energy, half mv square. Here we have written mv square by 2. That is similar to half mv square. And in last column, we have Ep plus Ek. That is sum of potential energy plus kinetic energy. Let's say we have m is equal to 20, as we have noticed here. G is 10 and H is at this time 4. So we have 20 into 10 into 4. So 20 into 10 into 4, we have 800 joule. Like that, we can put the value of different time interval at different position or say location of object. We can have this kind of table like this. Here we put m is equal to 20, g is equal to 10, and h here is 4 meter. So we have potential energy at highest height, that is 4 meter, is 800. At that time, we have mv square by 2. What is velocity at this time? The velocity at this time is 0. So we have kinetic energy 0. Now we have 3 meter distance. So we can have 20 into 10 into 3. So we have 600 joule. At this time, we can find kinetic energy as 200 joule. So we have some 600 plus 200, that is 800 joule. By putting different values, we can have this table. But the important thing to notice in this table is the sum of these two values, that is 800 plus 0, 600 plus 200, 400 plus 400, 200 plus 600, 0 plus 800 is 800. Which means total mechanical energy remains constant. Sum of potential energy and kinetic energy remains constant. So this is the thing we have to notice here. What would happen if nature had not allowed the transformation of energy? There is a view that life could not have been possible without transformation of energy. Do you agree with this? What do you think? Can we live without any transformation of energy? We cannot live without transformation of energy. Because we gain our energy from food, that is from chemical energy. We gain our energy from chemical energy to muscular energy. Whatever the vegetables we eat, that gains the energy from solar energy. So they convert solar energy into chemical energy. If this conversion of energy, this transformation of energy is not possible, there is no life on earth. So if transformation of energy will not be there, there is no life on earth or anywhere. Now we have important topic, that is rate of doing work. Rate of doing work. Do all of us work at the same rate? What is rate? Rate is a word which is related to time, or say time taken. Machines consume or transfer energy at the same rate. We know that capability of doing work of mine, of yours, are different. Capability of doing work of machines, different machines are different. So we can say that the rate is different. the time taken by machines, by all things are different for same thing. Agents that transfer energy to do work at a different rate. Let us understand with following activity. We have one activity to understand what is rate of doing work. Here we have activity number 11.16. Consider two children A and B. Let us say they weigh same. We have two children with same weight. Both start climbing up a rope separately. And they both start climbing the rope separately. Both reach 8 meter height by 15 second time, and while B take 20 second time to accomplish this task. They both reach at 8 meter. For that, A takes 15 second time and B takes 20 second time. What is the work done by each? At the 8 meter height, the work done or energy with this both children is MGH. Is nothing but MGH. So at final position, as they are start from the same position and reaches to same position, they have same work done. They have same work done. But the work done is same. However, has taken less time. A has taken less time than B to do this work. But as we can see here, A takes only 15 seconds while B takes 20 seconds. We can say that A climbs faster than B. Or we can say that A completed work more fast, more in less time. Who has done more work in given time second, given one time second frame? So we can easily say that child A take less time to climb the rope of 8 meter. So we can say that in 1 second time, child A do more work. So we can say that A done more work in 1 second of time. So here is our concept of rate of doing work. A stronger person may do certain work in relatively less time. More powerful vehicle would complete a journey in shorter time than less powerful one. We talk the power of machine like motorbike and motor cars. You have seen that or read that or even talk that my bike is very powerful. My car is very powerful. What is very powerful? Which means that it can cover large distance in shorter period of time. So that is the comparison of power. The speed with which this vehicle change energy or do work is basis for their classification. And this is the basis of classification. If it can cover more distance at in particular time frame, we can say that this is a more powerful vehicle. Powers measure the speed of work done. Remember, power measures the speed of work done. Power is a measure of speed of work done. More the power, less the time to do the work. More the power, less the time to do the work. Which means if I can do one particular work in less time compared to another person, I can say that I am more powerful in that particular work compared to this another person. How fast or slow work is done? The power is measure of how fast or slow the work is done. Power is defined as the rate of doing work or the rate of transfer of energy. What is power? Power is defined as rate of doing work or rate of transfer of energy. Rate of doing work or rate of transfer of energy. If an agent does work W in time T, then power is given by work divide time. Power is equal to work divide time. I would like to say that whenever you read rate of anything, there is must time in denominator in that equation. So here we have rate of doing work. So we have work divided time. So rate of anything is nothing but any quantity divide time. So power is equal to work divide time. We denote power by capital P letter, work by capital W, and time by small t. So we have one equation, P is equal to W by T. We know that the SI unit of work is joule and SI unit of time is second. So we can say that SI unit of power is joule per second. Joule per second. But in honor of James Watt, we gave a unit of power is watt, W-A-T-T. A unit of power is watt, and that is equal to joule per second. Having the symbol capital W, unit of power is watt, and it denote by letter capital W. 1 watt is the power of an agent which does work at rate of 1 joule per second. We can say that this particular machine, object, or anything has 1 watt power if it can do work with 1 joule per second. Per second it can do 1 joule work. So we can say that this object has power 1 watt. We can also say that 1 watt, when the rate of consumption of energy is 1 joule per second. Rate of consumption of energy is 1 joule per second. That is 1 watt power, which means that 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. Actually, this joule per second or watt is smaller unit. So in practical situation, we use kilowatt as larger unit of power. 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watt. We can write it as 1 small k capital W is equal to 1000 capital W, that is 1000 watt. And similarly, 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 joule per second, as 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. The power of an agent may vary with the time. Power can be vary with the time. So to neglect this variation and simplify calculation and situation, we take average power. So therefore, the concept of average power is useful. With fraction of second, machine can have different power in different time situation. So we have the concept of average power, and the average power is total energy consumed divide total time taken. Average power is total energy consumed by total time taken. So that is the concept of average power. Now we have the commercial unit of energy. Commercial unit of energy. Unit joule is too small. So we have to express this unit in larger term. So we use bigger unit of energy called kilowatt hour. Kilowatt hour. Unit of energy is joule. Unit of power is watt. So watt is equal to joule per second. So joule is equal to, we can say that, watt second. So larger unit of watt second is kilowatt hour. And we know this kilowatt hour unit by name unit. I hope you heard that power consumption of electricity consumption of your last 2 months is 200 unit, 300 unit, 500 unit. You may heard this kind of word that we consume 500 unit, 200 unit, 100 unit in last 2 months. That word unit, that unit is nothing but kilowatt hour. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 kilowatt into 1 hour. 1 kilowatt is 1000 watt and 1 hour is 3600 seconds. So 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 joule. So the energy used in household, industry and commercial establishments are usually expressed in kilowatt hour. And we simply called it as unit. For example, electrical energy used during a month is expressed in terms of units, as we discussed. So I hope you got the topic of rate of doing work, that is power, different unit of power, and commercial unit of energy, that is kilowatt hour. Thank you.